Okay, so this is the first in a series of tutorials about using images in processing. For now, we'll just be gathering images and drawing them to the screen or chunks of those images. Later on, we'll learn how to deal with smaller chunks, basically pixels, for these images and manipulate those or use those in some way to draw things onto the screen. So let's go ahead and dive right in. I've created an example sketch. With setup and draw. I'm not drawing anything to the screen. I chose the size because this is the size of the image that I'm going to use. So it depends on what you're trying to do with whatever size you would like to use. This is also a default sketch right now. And if I add any images to this in kind of an automated way through processing, if I drag and drop images into the editor here, processing will put these images in a directory for that project, but since I'm just using a default, you know, sketch blah 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 project, processing isn't going to know what to do with it. Well, it's going to know what to do with it, but it's going to have to create a temporary file somewhere. And just it's good practice to go ahead and save and have your own sketch where you want it, so you know where to find those files if you need them. So let's just do save. And let's just put this on the desktop. PImage tutorial 1. Let's just do that. Okay, so that's on my desktop. We'll just leave it over here so I can find it. And what we're going to do is add some images. So if I look in here, sorry, I keep getting emails. Let's turn the email off. If I look at the sketch, you can see that I have the sketch, the PDE file, and I have this properties. I'm going to go ahead and add. I have these two really dorky images of myself. There's one that's pretty outstanding, right? And there's another. So during this tutorial, I'm going to eventually use multiple images and tell processing to choose different chunks and reassemble a kind of collage of my face. So, but for now, let's just start with the two images, and I'm just going to add them. So if I click and drag and put that into the processing file, you can see a data folder has now been created. Down here above the console, it says one file added to the sketch. And in the data folder, there is that image. So it made a duplicate of it. And if I open up that folder and I add Dane underscore 2, you can see now it created a new one, one file added to the sketch. So those are now in the directory. So when I call them, I don't have to call out an absolute file path. I can just say, hey, grab Dane1, and it knows that it's in the project folder, right? So the other thing too, in your naming construction, naming conventions, do not use spaces. No spaces. And it's also not a bad idea if you had a series of images like I'm going to use for this. Later on, we'll see how I can load all these at once using a kind of simplification of a string, something called concatenation, to say, hey, load Dane 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever. So if you're loading these, go ahead and use whatever the name, if you're using yourself or some other celebrity, use a generic name like celebrity and underscore 1, 2, 3, 4, however many you're going to use. All right, so let's load. Let's go ahead and put the PImage here, and we'll call this Dane 1. Oops. And I'm going to put another one here, image Dane 2. All right, so those are loaded in the scene. When I run it, I don't have any problems. Sorry, they've been declared. They have not been loaded. Let me correct myself. Those haven't been loaded yet, but I've declared that I'm going to have an image named Dane 1 and Dane 2, but now I need to load them. So I'm going to say Dane 1 equals load image. And you can see as I type that out and I start put the parentheses there, that load image becomes blue, so I know that it's a keyword within the API. And within quotes, we'll say Dane1.jpg. Right? And I'm just going to copy this. Do it again. This time this will be Dane 2, and Dane 2 is going to be loaded from the other. All right, so let's go ahead and run and see if we get any errors. We do not, so I have done my work correctly so far. So I've declared, let's put this up here, declare, or deluxe, whatever, declare the variable. So we tell processing that we're going to use that. And we initialize the variable. IE load image. And then down here in draw, we can actually do something with it. So let's say image. And so image just says, let's draw an image to the screen. I have to tell processing which one it's going to be. So let's do Dane 1. And I'll just say 0 and 0, which just means the x coordinate will be up in the top, which is the top left corner of the image. This will be in the top left corner of the sketch. And you see, I've loaded an image inside of there, right? Big whoop. Okay, but that's a start. So we've loaded that image. There's all kinds of different things that we could do from here. But let's see where we're at in this tutorial. I think what we'll do is stop there, just so you can see that we've loaded an image. We've started to set this up. We've actually loaded two images, but we're only drawing one to the screen, right? Maybe the last thing I'll show is with the image, this is the name of it, and this is the size, but then how big should that be? How big of it should the image itself be, okay, when we load that? So let's just tell it to be smaller than it. Let's see, let's go ahead and make it 800, but this time let's just make it 1,000 units. Oops, let's make it 500. So what you see is we've squished the image, okay, for no other reason than just to show that we can do it. And let's draw another image, but this time let's use Dane 2. Let's have it be 0 in the X, but height divided by 2. So we see, and this is kind of going off the edge of the screen capture here, but hopefully you can see that it's drawn one image and it started to draw a second image with my hat on the other direction. Boy, those are really disturbing, right? So let's just delete that for now. Let's put this back to 1,000. Okay. So we'll stop right there. This is just the basics of loading an image. So let's go over the main points here. Declaring the variable, so we tell it that we're going to use PImage and it's going to have a name. And then we use that name and associate it and initialize it with this variable, or with this file path to the image that we're going to use. So we're going to load the image. We give it the exact name. Spelling, spaces, all this counts. You can't, if I put a capital D in here, it's not going to work, right? So it's got to be the right stuff. And then we go ahead and draw an image to the screen, and this time we're using Dane 1. If I wanted to, I can change it to Dane 2, right? And a less crazy, more stern image of me, all right? So we'll go ahead and stop right there. Part 2 to come.